Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Minding the Gap. I'm Sue Hodgman, and this is Greg Allen behind the camera. We're bringing you some helpful information on taking care of yourself emotionally and mentally during and after this COVID emergency. In collaboration with San Juan County, San Juan Safe Communities, and the Mental Health Task Force, we're giving experts a few moments to share helpful ideas and tips on important subjects like anxiety, depression, grief, and many other important issues we're all facing right now. Today, we have Jessica Stepani, Executive Director of Masada House, sharing information on recovery.
We at Masada House would like everyone who is in recovery or considering recovery to know that you are not alone. We understand that recovery can be a struggle at times, and these past few months have been especially trying. You are not alone. Masada House is a transitional sober living home for women in recovery from substance abuse. Our mission is to provide people recovering from substance abuse a safe, secure home in which to live and to practice the skills taught to them in treatment so that they may become productive members of their community. Basically, what that boils down to is that we provide support, structure, and resources to each of our residents and occasionally other community members. We would like to offer some suggestions for ways to stay clean and sober. The first thing, of course, is don't use drugs and alcohol. We understand that this is not as easy as it sounds, and it can be more difficult if you are surrounded by others who are drinking and using. Second, establish and stick to a routine. As addicts and alcoholics, it's important for us to keep busy and maintain healthy routines. For many people, this means getting up at a regular time, getting dressed, working out or going to work, gardening, household chores, getting creative, etc. Find a schedule with activities that interest you and keep you and your mind busy. Third, remember that there are a lot of people from all walks of life who are in recovery and who, given the chance, would like to share what worked for them. Many of these can be found via 12-step groups such as AA, NA, or faith-based groups. We suggest that you explore your options and find what works best for you. AA and NA have 24-hour hotlines that you can call to talk to others in recovery. Many of the local churches have faith-based groups that you can join. If you are not already in a treatment program, you might want to consider either inpatient or outpatient treatment somewhere like Four Winds Recovery Center or Cottonwood Clinical Services. Treatment helps teach you the tools you'll need to ease your journey of recovery. That, in addition to 12-step or self-help groups, help keep you busy and provide suggestions for daily living. Masada House provides its residents a place to live and practice using the tools of recovery provided in treatment. During the COVID stay-at-home orders, many of the 12-step meetings, group therapies, and faith-based groups have turned to technology to help keep people connected. Many are utilizing Zoom to continue meeting safely. As addicts, it is important that we stay connected to others who are also in recovery. These are people we can talk to and who understand what it is we are going through. As places begin opening up, some of the groups are beginning to meet in person while still incorporating Zoom. This ensures that everyone is able to stay connected at their own comfort level. If you do choose to go to an in-person meeting, please practice social distancing and wear a mask, as many addicts have underlying health issues. If you would like more information about Masada House, please feel free to contact me, Jessica Stepani, at 505-360-4672. Or through email, masadahouse0@gmail.com, or on Facebook. We are taking applications at this time, and please check out our website at masadahouse.com.
Thank you, Jessica. You can reach out to Jessica at the information listed on the screen. We'll be bringing you another Minding the Gap episode soon, and in the meantime, our resource page can be found at the San Juan County website, San Juan Safe Communities website, and the Mental Health Task Force Facebook page.